In the capital, Chief Election Commissioner V. Sampath announcing the dates. Rahul Gandhi, already well entrenched into the election campaign, as part of his outreach program. He was in Pune with the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Prithviraj Chavan, and of course, Arvind Kejriwal trying to oust Rahul Gandhi from the battle against Narendra Modi. He landed in Gujarat. He's going to hold a roadshow and says he's going to test. He's going to test Narendra Modi's claims in Gujarat. Rohit Singh is joining us from Patna. Rohit, clearly Nitish Kumar, Bihar and UP are going to be the game changers in this election. We're already seeing alliances being formed, Congress and RJD perhaps going to formally announce their alliance.
Well, absolutely. Bihar is a very crucial state and it will be playing a very important role as far as government formation is concerned in May. It's going to be a triangular contest also, because it's like the BJP and Ram Vilas Paswan on one side, we have the JDU on the other end, and the new combination, the Congress and RJD alliance on the third side. It's going to be a triangular contest, and after the election dates have been announced, it's a six-phase poll that will be taking place in Bihar, and most of the parties have welcomed these six-phase polls in Bihar. I have with me State President of RJD, Ram Chandra Purove, with me. Let's get in a reaction from him as well. Ram Chandra Purove ji, छह चरणों में चुनाव होने वाला है बिहार में, कैसे देखते हैं आप इसे?
चुनाव आयोग के द्वारा लोकसभा चुनाव की जो तिथि घोषित की गई है, छह चरण में चुनाव होना है बिहार में, इस घोषणा का मैं स्वागत करता हूं। सिर्फ चुनाव आयोग से हमारी यही अपेक्षा है कि फेयर इम्पार्शियल चुनाव हो, और ऐसी व्यवस्था चुनाव आयोग के द्वारा की जानी चाहिए ताकि सभी मतदाता और खास करके कमजोर वर्ग के जो मतदाता हैं वे मतदान केंद्र पर पहुंचे।
खासकर नक्सली एरिया है बिहार जो है उसको लेकर।
यस, सिर्फ नक्सली एरिया नहीं बल्कि कुछ ऐसे एरिया हैं जहां कमजोर वर्ग के लोगों को चुनाव मतदान केंद्र तक जाने में दिक्कत होती है, तो वहाँ पर एक्स्ट्रा सिक्योरिटी फोर्स की व्यवस्था चुनाव आयोग के द्वारा की जानी चाहिए। हमें आशंका है कि बिहार में जो राष्ट्रीय जनता दल और जो कांग्रेस का जो गठबंधन है, और इस गठबंधन का जो असर पूरे बिहार में है, लालू प्रसाद यादव के नेतृत्व में जो चुनावी सभा चल रही है और हजारों लाखों की संख्या में भीड़ जुट रही है, तो कहीं ना कहीं रूलिंग पार्टी के द्वारा कुछ चुनाव में जो भ्रष्टाचार की व्यवस्था की आशंका हमको दिख रही है, तो चुनाव आयोग को पूरे तौर पर सतर्क रहना चाहिए, सचेत होना चाहिए, ताकि हमारा जो वोटर्स है, क्योंकि हमारा एक ही उद्देश्य है कि हम लालू प्रसाद यादव सांप्रदायिक शक्तियों के खिलाफ लड़ रहे हैं, और हमारा चुनाव का नारा है कि मोदी भगाओ देश बचाओ, बिहार मतलब नीतीश भगाओ और बिहार को बचाओ। ऐसी परिस्थिति में आशंका हो सकती है कि हमारे मतदाताओं को लोग डिस्टर्ब करें,
लेकिन well, मारू, वी हैव सीन दैट द आरजेडी इज एक्सप्रेसिंग एप्रीहेंशंस दैट द रूलिंग जेडीयू गवर्नमेंट कुड लाइक साबोटाज और डिस्टर्ब द इलेक्शन कैंपेन ऑफ आरजेडी एंड इनफैक्ट लालू प्रसाद यादव, एंड दैट इज व्हाई दे आर वांटिंग दैट पैरामिलिट्री फोर्सेस शुड बी डिप्लॉयड इन द स्टेट सो दैट देयर इज नो डिस्टर्बशन दैट टेक्स प्लेस।
राइट, Rohit, stay on with us. Javed, I want to come to you. One is Bihar, the other is Uttar Pradesh, really, isn't it?
Yes. These two states will decide whether Mr. Narendra Modi becomes Prime Minister or not. There are 120 seats for grabs. Right now, the BJP has a negligible. They had only 10 seats in Uttar Pradesh, handful in Bihar. And unless they can multiply that, Mr. Modi would be hard put. But all indications coming out of both Bihar and Uttar Pradesh are that he will do exceedingly well. And if indeed that does happen to be the case, then I think his task of becoming India's next Prime Minister would be that much easier.
And Prem Vada is joining us from another crucial state, Tamil Nadu. 24th April is going to be the date when the whole of Tamil Nadu goes to the polls. And Jayalalitha, of course, the power that she might have in this election and she might exude post-elections is going to be huge. Prem Vada.
Absolutely, Maruk. It remains to be seen whether Jayalalitha is going to go back to her good friend and someone whom she has described as a good administrator. Joining me is a senior political analyst and journalist, Mr. Kolapan. How do you read the situation here in Tamil Nadu? What kind of fight is it going to be? Is it going to, at this point of time, it does look like a four-cornered fight. What do you think?
As of now, it looks like that there will be four corner contest, but the situations may change, because as far as we know, that there is a sympathy. I won't call it a sympathy. There is a wave in favor of Modi. There is a perception we are gathering from every nooks and corner of the state. And though every political party has begun their election work, no alliance is able to firm up seat sharing talks with their alliance partners. For example, though Chief Minister Jayalalitha launched their campaign 2 days ago, she is not yet firmed up her seat sharing talks with two left parties. And in the DMK front, yesterday they finalized seat sharing with two of his allies, but the talks are still going on with two more allies. The BJP is trying to bring together a rainbow kind of alliance, all political parties like PMK, Vaikobal Sabi, Marumala Chitravada Munnetra Kalakam, and actor Vijay Gandhi, DMTK. But there is no sign whether these are coming together or disintegrating. So far, there is no clear picture. As of now, only the ADMK started a campaign, right. Others are still lagging behind.
Absolutely. So as he says, nothing is firmed up here, but anything can happen in a post-poll scenario. But at this point of time, it looks like a four-cornered fight here. And there are chances, and as he's pointing out, the ground reports suggest
right.
The BJP, which hardly had even 0.1% vote share here in Tamil Nadu, the voter base seems to have increased now.
Thanks so much for that, Priyamvada.